So I increased my hip size now. Okay, and so how to increase? Go to run configuration and then go to argument, and here I am using 2 GB minimum size and 4 GB maximum size. Okay, for this I am able to deploy my application in run mode. Okay, now next thing. So if we go inside cache, okay, so in key expression we are using this variable transport company, okay, and this variable we will get value in this variable when we will get either when we will pass in query parameter, when we will pass this company name. Okay, we are create at the starting only, if you remember, we are creating that variable transport company name. Okay, so when we are getting this query parameter, at that time we are getting this transport company name. But in default case, in this case, we will not get this transport company name. So what we need to do here, we will need to create two variables, one variable for this case and one variable for this flow. Okay, in each flow I need to create this variable. Okay, and what will be value of that variable? Fast go and second time it will be, in second flow it will be travel on tip. Variable name will be same. Okay, and then in flow reference we will call that API, we will get data, here also we will get data, and then we'll see in logger we will get final payload, that will be combination of these two. Okay, so let me save this and let me try it again in debug mode. I already increased hip size from 2 GB to 4 GB. If it is working in debug mode then fine, otherwise we will move to run mode. deployment done. Okay, so it failed somewhere. Okay, so we have only one solution here we need to run in. We have to start in run mode, then only we will not get this Java error, means heap out of memory error. So let me start in run mode. Okay, and somewhere it failed, we'll check where it failed. I think it's failing in fastgo root implementation. And this one is system API. Okay, it's failing in fastgo system API call. So deployment done. Let me rerun it. Okay, so in run mode also we will get error. So with the help of console we need to identify. Okay, so what it's saying, info okay, we got success response. Okay, so you can see here, as I told, we are calling two system here, fastgo also and travel ntip also, and we did login of payload. Okay, so this one you can see we are getting payload like this. Okay, but here you can see actual payload. So in payload we have one set from fastgo. Okay, this set we are getting from travel on tip, and second set we are getting from fastgo. But I want to, okay, this one is also from travel on tip only. First one, this one is from fastgo and this one from travel on tip. But now I want to merge these two payload. Okay, and I want to send back. Okay, so first thing, how to get this first payload? Okay, so this payload is inside main payload. So if you go through scatter gather, then what will happen? This one also generate one payload, this one also will generate one payload. Okay, and after this scatter gather, you will get payload inside payload. So if I want to access first payload, then syntax will be payload 0 payload. Let me run this. Actually, if we will work on debug mode, then it will be very easy. But here, no, it will be very difficult to identify. It should be payload 0 dot payload or payload. Actually, 0 should be in single inverted comma. That part I am not sure. Okay, deployment done. Okay, this is invalid script. Actually, I forgot exact syntax. Okay, deployment done. Let me clean all the log. Okay, so this time you can see when I did payload single inverted comma 0 dot payload, so I am getting this first payload. Okay, we are getting in this format, array format. Okay. Okay, so we are getting in this format. Second one also we will get in this format, but I will not keep it separately in two array. I want to keep in single array. Okay, for this also we will have one array. This array will contain two object, and for second one also we will have two array. Okay, so how we can remove this kind of thing? We want to keep maintain one array. Okay, so first we need to convert this array into object. Okay, so for conversion of array into object, what we have map function, payload map here if I will put payload directly, then what will happen? It will not work. So we need to do mapping one by one. Again there will be one array. Okay, do we have anything to merge two array? Let me see. So we have first array, this one is example. We have second array, okay. Expected output, we want one area. This one, exactly we want this one, okay. So what they are saying, data view in one employee, this map entry. Map entry, then entry. Let me see if we have any another way. P2 filter. Okay, so this one is working, but we need to identify how they did. IN1, this one, map entry arrow entry plus IN2 filter dollar dot employee ID equals to entry dot employee ID map dollar minus employee ID. Client ID null, employee ID 1, employee ID. Okay, so this one is merging two. Okay, no, we don't need this one. Oh, both of them for to merge two. But what exactly he want? One, another has 3, 2. This one has 3, 2, 1. Oh, okay, we don't want this one. We have some other requirement, but let me see if we can utilize any concept from here. LID name, RID name, LID, RID, LID, RID. Left join, outer join, join. Last time we discuss about some functionality in a pluck and some other reduce one. So in reduce we are adding from first to last. Here reduce will work. This one is array. Okay, so in this way we are getting object of object, and then if I want to merge two object, no, 1 minute. Company code fast go. Okay, everything coming in one. No, this one also we don't need. Okay, first let me try what result we will get. We are getting two array. If we will combine first and second, okay, first let me see. Actually this part I have handled long back, so I unable to recall what exactly I did. So what is the problem here? Now we are getting inside payload, we are getting two payload. Now we need to merge those two payload. Okay, and both payload contain array. Deployment done. Okay, this one will not work. In which way I can merge those two? I can't run in debug mode also, otherwise it will be easy to identify. Oh, we can add in this easy way. So we have this array and we have second array, and if I do plus plus, then it will make okay. Then we have very easy way to do this. Payload dot 0 dot payload, okay, and then plus plus, okay, in both case we'll add default value. Default will have one array. Payload, okay, and then okay, this one will be payload one. Payload dot 0 dot payload, first payload, default value will be array. Payload dot 1 dot payload, second payload. Actually, I will explain this part. Let me first do this. Okay. Default. Okay. This one we are keeping inside logger. And let me do set payload also. Hope this will work. Let me see. Okay, deployment done. Okay, so we are getting. Okay, let me explain this one. So what for these two case we are clear, like we will get one payload, we are just doing required mapping and we are sending back. For this also we are doing same, we are calling one API, we are getting response, we are doing mapping, we are sending back. But in this case what will happen, in first case you will get one payload, second case we will get one payload. So when you will use scatter gather, then it finally it will return payload of payload. Okay, so inside payload you will have two payload. Okay, so you will have this kind of structure. For example, this one is our payload, inside this payload we have one payload this, another payload this. In our case we are getting inside payload we are getting array of object. Okay, so what I want to do, I want to add this array of object. So simple syntax we will use plus plus. Okay, so what it will do, it will add object of two array and it will create one final array. Okay, for example if I add here till this point each array has only one object now. Okay, so I am adding here also. So now each array has two object, so finally it will create array of four object. Okay, so same way we applied here, what we did in payload, we are adding payload. So first payload how we can get, we for that we have this syntax payload, then inside single inverted comma zero that dot payload. So in this way you will get first payload, means whatever payload you will get from here. Okay, and I want second payload and I want to add, so plus plus payload dot one dot payload, so to get this second payload. And what I am doing, I am adding, so finally it will give us final payload this one. So see, first go first object, second object of first go, then third one from travel on tip, fourth one also from travel on tip. It's not required like only two will be there, this can be one, this can be three. Okay, any means number of payload will come and we can add. Okay, so in this way we completed this process API. So for this process API, let me check anything is missing. No, we are done with this process API. Only thing we can optimize, one thing I observed, see same structure is there here and there, everything is same. So if we want, we can make it single flow only. Okay, single sub flow only, but for that we have to do some manipulation. So for now I don't want to do, but yes we can do. For that we need to put some effort. For example, this path will be dynamic. For in case of route this path should be different, in case of schedule this path should be like this, and with schedule. So what we can do, we can apply choice and we can set variable based on the transport company name. That we can do, but for now we are not going to do. So we are done with this process API. Okay, now we'll do code checking. Okay, so where is my process API? I will go to GitHub desktop. I will fetch latest change. So you need to write appropriate comment here. So we are done with means we faced all the latest change. So always try it, means whenever you will do code commit or whenever you will pull code, so must check your last fetched is should be just now. Okay, commit in develop branch and push it. Okay, so till this point we are done with SAPI, both the external API, both the SAPI and one process API. Now we are left with experience API, two experience API that we will do in next session. Okay, in process API, okay, one thing still pending. Yeah, I can remember. If you see in this mapping, we are getting this location description. We are getting this hard-coded location description. Okay, so here we have hard-coded, but actually we will get this value from JSON file. Okay, so this this part I will show in next session. Okay, so for that actually we need to create JSON file, then we will include that JSON file using read URL, and then we will apply filter condition to check this location description, means for which location code, which location description we need. So I will show you in next session. Okay, so we'll connect in next session and we'll do this, and then we'll start Experience API. And again, Experience API will be very simple tool, like to SAPI. Only every time complex part will be this Process API.